to the beginning a number of inquiries, so we just thought we'd just combo it with everybody regarding the incidents last night. I wanted to first extend our heartfelt condolences to the victims and their families from the events of last night. It's just tragic. Our hearts are broken, and it's been a sad day around here. So as far as, you know, what we're doing and next steps, I wanted to, we've been meeting with the folks at Cornish and Ballpark Village and Delaware North Sports Service on all sorts of aspects of the security around here. I think you all know that we are on the cutting edge in the ballpark with our DHS designation, which we got recently, which outlines so much of the things that we've been doing on the security front. You know, we're really at the cutting edge there. We also share a number of security resources with Ballpark Village and the staff over there. They have very strong security protocols. There were a number of officers there last night. And, the events over there are always have a high level of security. There's a police substation over there. There's 24/7 security. But the events of last night, kind of reinforce that things still can't happen, no matter how diligent you are. So we've been working today on talking about some things we can do in the future to make sure something like this doesn't happen. It was a private event that we have had here in the past a couple of times, Sunday afternoon at 4. It's been a nice event for us, and it's not the type of event that you would have ever thought something like this could happen at. So I don't think there's any way anyone could have predicted this sort of violence would have broken out given our history with this group. And so I think as we look forward, I was just on the phone with Captain Sean Dace, who is, head of homicide investigations with the city. He did not have any real new information for me relative to what they had given you all last night. They are obviously following up on leads as it relates to security camera, eyewitnesses, as well as having interviewed the surviving victim in the hospital today. So they're working very hard. He assures me that they are doing everything they can to get to the bottom of this and find the person responsible. So as you know, we're jumping into a homestand, and it will be business as usual. We need to get ready for that. But I think we've all taken a pause today to make sure that we look really hard at everything we're doing across the street, as well as in this facility, Busch Stadium. And we feel really good about the fact that this is a very safe place to be on both sides of the street, and will be going forward. So with that, maybe I'll open up to a few questions if you guys have
any. Mr. DeWitt, can you speak to who is in charge of determining the type of security when it comes to a private event like that? Is it dictated by Ballpark Village, or is it up to the promoter of the event?
It's a combination, because there's a certain baseline level of security that Ballpark Village has. And usually the person that works the event on behalf of Ballpark Village works through security issues as well with the promoters, or if they're working with the organizer of an event as well. So that's a collaborative approach that takes place for all the events.
So are you evaluating security protocols there now in anticipation of changing them, or maybe you could be a little more specific in characterizing what it is you're looking at over there?
Well, anytime something like this happens, you always take a step back and reevaluate. And that's what we have been doing all day today with our partners at Ballpark Village. Delaware North is our partner here, and they actually manage Cardinals Nation. So we've all been talking today about what our protocols are and ideas for making them stronger going forward.
So I have a question. This incident last night follows the incident last year where the woman was hit by a stray bullet during the ball game. It's hard to recall two incidents like this occurring at other sports-related, I'll call them sports-related venues. Are you at all discouraged at all by this and the effect it could have on the mindset of fans moving down the road with incidents like these?
Well, first of all, I don't link those two together at all. I mean, one's just a random stray event that happened. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we took that very seriously and did our homework on what happened and how to prevent it, but this is a whole other thing, I think. Of course we're worried about perceived safety from our fans and our guests. It's the most important thing that we have to make sure is there, is safety for our guests. And so, like I said, anytime something like this happens, you take a hard look and say, could we have done anything to prevent it? And number one, and two, what do we need to do going forward to prevent it? Anything that is happening again. There are certain things that, I don't want to make excuses, but there are certain things that are out there in the world we live in that are risks no matter what you do. But that doesn't, it's not an excuse for not doing absolutely everything that is within your control to do to prevent things from like this happening.
You mentioned, there was a time when there were signs, and there still are signs, but there were no metal detectors, just saying you can't bring a gun into the ballpark. And there are signs at Ballpark Village saying no firearms. Is it time to consider metal detectors to get in over there? I mean, you just can't count on the decency of people to not bring a firearm where they're not supposed to bring a firearm. Obviously, someone brought one in there last night.
Yeah.
And you just...
You're right. We are posted, which means that we have the restricted list of things that you're allowed to bring in, both in the ballpark and Ballpark Village, which is allowed under our concealed carry law as a preventative measure in private places. We are posted over there, so obviously the person who walked in with that firearm was doing so against our stated policy in the door.
Right.
There wasn't metal detection last night. As I said, we had this event before. It's been a great event for us. It's Sunday afternoon. It's a good group to have, and it's just not something we would have predicted. Now, will we do metal detection for private events in the future? I think we need to look at that. I mean, I think everybody would agree that there's a difference between four people coming to dinner or having an outing and what your security protocol should be and having a World Series game at Busch Stadium. I mean, so somewhere in that spectrum fell this event, right? I guess armchair quarterback, you could say, yeah, wish we had metal detection, but I think when you look at what this event has been for us in the past, it's been a very nice, well-behaved type of situation, so I don't think anybody could have predicted this. We'll look at this, though, and I think make a judgment going forward on what should reach that level, and maybe it's a balancing act on a whole bunch of things. You've got metal detection, you have rapid response teams, you have bomb-sniffing dogs, all of which we have at every game here at Busch Stadium. Should they be at every event, private event in town that has more than 100 people? I don't know. That's
right.
A hard question. I think we have to be smart about it and thoughtful about it. But somewhere along that spectrum, we need to draw a line and say, this qualifies for this level of security. Maybe this level doesn't.
Would you book this event?
I think we haven't really talked about it. I think we're really focused on happened, paying our respects to the victims, and, you know, we're just, it's too early to say.
Do you think fans will see anything immediately this week change at Ballpark Village in terms of security protocols or anything like that?
We've talked about beefing up the protocols over there during game days, and yes, there will be some enhancements. Some of those, I think I'll just leave vague because there is an element here of not wanting to telegraph everything you're doing from a security standpoint. We give you guys the big picture things that we're doing. Obviously, Homeland Security publishes sort of, or promulgates huge rules as to what requires certification, so you can see that we do all that stuff, but we also do other stuff. I think working with our partners at Cordish, we have a number of things that we have decided to kind of either strengthen or do new, and some of them are have already been in the works, might take a little longer, call it a month or two or whatever, to kind of get to another level over there. But I hate to get into specifics. I think the answer, the short answer is yes. If you look hard enough, you'll see some things.
So do you think anything immediate, do you think anything obvious right away, like bags being searched or metal detectors right away this week, or?
Well, we do metal detection already for those areas that face the ballpark, whether it's the AT&T rooftop, you know, the seating areas and so forth. And so I think, you know, we're gonna look at ways to expand that, subject to some timing issues and availability issues and things like that.
What is your overall reaction to what's happened?
Disgusted, alarmed, and sad. My heart goes out to the families and to the victims. And, you know, I understand the gentleman passed as a father and newly married, and it was his birthday. I mean, just the kind of person you'd want coming to celebrate at Ballpark Village. And so to have this happen is devastating and something that we never want to have happen again.
Have you been in contact with the family?
I have not. I think based on advice just from law enforcement, I think they want to get through all the interviews and all the immediate things that they need to do to just kind of do what they do. And then certainly we will eventually reach out in some way.
Bill, did you have anything? You mentioned speaking with Captain Dace. It was a captain, I can't remember, but
yeah.
Was there anything in there, a little nugget you can share that might help? Or was there any discussion of a boost in the reward? I know Crime Stoppers, it's 5,000. I don't know if he said, hey, we're on to somebody, or if there's any word on, do they know who did this? Are they closing in, or anything that you feel is reassuring about where they are?
Yeah, I mean, I think they're good at this kind. I mean, it was a well-attended party. I mean, it was a public situation. I mean, there were a lot of people that I feel confident that they're gonna find this guy.